So a cool new function that's in Pages 6.1 on the Mac is the ability to insert mathematical equations. You can do this using the insert equation function. When you do, you get this little dialog box that comes up here, edit equation, and it tells you you can use two different formats. One is called LaTeX and the other MathML. Now they both are very different from each other, but they have the similarity in that you can type normal text that then is translated into something that looks like an equation. For instance, using LaTeX we can use powers. So for instance, if you wanted to say like 9 squared, you could type 9 and then a caret symbol, which is on American keyboards shift and 6, and then 2. And then I hit insert, but even before I do so I can see a representation of the function right there. I hit insert and I get this here. It's this special little box that flows in with the text. And if I double click it I can edit it again. So it's not just normal characters there. It's a special type of element. Now you can do lots of different things. Like for instance, instead of a caret I can do an underscore, which is shift and then dash on American keyboards. And you can see it puts the number down a little bit. I can also do other things, like for instance a square root function is backslash sqrt and then a left bracket, which is shift in the square bracket on American keyboards, and then you could put a number and then the right curly bracket there, and you could take it square root of 9. Also you can do fractions. So you can do backslash frac and then you have to do two numbers in curly brackets, like let's say 7 and 28. And now I get a fraction there. It's not as easy as just the little 1/2 and 1/3 that you can get with some fonts. This is actually any kind of fraction you want. So I can hit update there and you can see it's a special character here with this fraction. And you can combine this for all sorts of things. So I could put instead of 28, for instance, I could do backslash square root and then curly bracket 28 in there. And you can see it's 7 over the square root of 28. So there's lots of different things that you can do with LaTeX. It is spelled L-A-T-E-X and it's got a capital T and a capital X. And you can search the internet. There's tons of tutorials for using this because this has been used by lots of different software for decades to type mathematical equations. So if you want to learn more about it, just do some tutorials that are online that go into detail. And there's references, even entire books that are written about how to use this type of thing to do mathematical equations. If you're using some software that generates mathematical equations, quite often you can export an equation in LaTeX format and then you can paste it here to include it in Pages. Likewise, MathML is the same kind of thing, except it's a little more complex. So let's take a look at the Wikipedia pages for both of these. Here's LaTeX and you've got some examples here of how LaTeX looks. You can see some complex examples there. You've got some history of it. MathML is far harder to actually type out. It looks like HTML, but it's special for math. So it's pretty complex. It's not the sort of thing you would normally type on your own. Normally you would use a special app that generates equations, or maybe you find an equation somewhere and they would include a link to a MathML version of it. And then you would copy and paste. So for instance, here in Wikipedia, there's an example. I'm going to select that, copy it, go over to Pages again and paste it in there. And you can see it interprets it perfectly. And there's that equation just as it was represented on Wikipedia. So you have those two different options for typing complex mathematical equations and then using them in Pages. You can also do this in Numbers and Keynote as well. They work just like regular things. I can copy and paste the equation there and you can see I've got it in a different block. I can center it, all sorts of things. I can't really style it in any way because if I change the font you can see it's not going to do anything. It's relying on the fact that it is a good font for representing some of the math stuff here. But you can change things like the size, for instance, if you want. So you can play around with that. But it's a great addition for anybody needing to do work that includes math equations in their Pages documents.